Good morning. Myself Chandra Mohan, Assistant Professor, St. Martin's Engineering College. So today I'm going to explain about evaluation of double integrals and change of order of integration. Okay. So evaluation of double integral. Okay. So let us see. So how to evaluate double integral. So for example, if the given double integral is like x is equal to a to b, y is equal to f1 of x, f2 of x, dy dx. So if the given double integral is like integral x is equal to a to b, integral y is equal to f1 of x to f2 of x, dy dx. So here the interior limits. The interior integral limits are functions of x. So we have to take these limits as y limits. So y is equal to f1 of x to f2 of x, and then the exterior integral limits belongs to x. Okay. So one limits, interior limits we have to take either functions of x or functions of y, and then exterior limits we have to take as constants. Okay. So for this, so first we have integration with respect to y. Y is equal to f1 of x to f2 of x dy, and then integration with respect to x. Okay. So or if the given double integral is like y is equal to a to b, x is equal to f1 of y to f2 of y dx dy. So here the interior limits are functions of y. So first we have integration with respect to x and then with respect to y. Like integral y is equal to a to b. So integral x is equal to f1 of y to f2 of y dx and then dy. So integration first with respect to x and then with respect to y. So this is about evaluation of double integrals. So if all the four limits like x is equal to a to b and y is a to b and c to d, if all the four limits are constant, so then you can integration first either with respect to x and with respect to y, or first with respect to y and then with respect to x. So you can take any order to evaluate this integral. Okay. So now let us see change of order of integration. Change of order of integration. Okay. So change of order of integration means change of order of limits. Okay. So either if the given integral is like integral x is equal to a to b, integral y is equal to y1 of x to y2 of x. Okay. So if the given integral limits like this, okay, so first we have integration with respect to y and then with respect to x. Okay. So this is before changing the limits. So after changing the limits, we have to first integration with respect to x. X is equal to x1 of y, x2 of y, and then with respect to y. Y is equal to a to b. Okay. So this is before changing the limits. So these are after changing the limits. Okay. So first here, so by according to given integral, first we have to integration with respect to y, right? So by changing the order of integration, first we have to integration with respect to x and then with respect to y. So finally, the change of order of integration means change of order of the limits. Okay. So for that, so to find these change in limits, so we have it is better to draw a rough sketch about the given region. So by using the given limits. So for example, if you take this example, 0 to 1, 0 to square root of 1 minus x square y square dy dx. Okay. So by evaluate this double integral by changing the order of integration. Okay. So according to given problem, here the interior limits. So what are interior limits here? 0 to square root of 1 minus x square. So these are functions of x, right? So we have to take these limits as y. Y is equal to 0 to square root of 1 minus x square. So here the interior limits belongs to what? Y. So then exterior limits belongs to x. X is equal to 0 to 1. Okay? So according to given problem, first we have to integration with respect to y. Okay? So y square dy and then with respect to x dx. Okay? So now by changing the order of integration, here the interior limits we have to take as x limits. X is equal to function of y and the y limits as a constant. So for that, so we have to draw a rough sketch about to find the region of the integration. So by drawing these lines, x is equal to 0, x is equal to 1, and y is equal to 0, y is equal to square root of 1 minus x square. Okay, so by drawing these two lines and these two curves, so we can find the required limits. Okay, so here y is equal to square root of 1 minus x square means, so by squaring on both sides you get y square is equal to 1 minus x square, and take x square to the left side, then x square plus y square is equal to 1. So x square plus y square is equal to 1 is nothing but circle equation with center 0, 0 and radius is 1 unit. So it is unit circle, center at 0, 0 and radius is 1 unit. So draw center at 0, 0 and radius is 1 unit. Okay, so this point becomes 1, 0. On x axis y coordinate is 0, so it is minus 1, 0. So this is 0, 1. On y axis x coordinate is 0 and it is 0, -1. Okay, so now first we have to identify the required region, so bounded by these two lines and these two curves. Okay, so clearly y is equal to 0 means x axis, right? So y 0, so on x axis y is equal to 0 and x is equal to 0 means y axis, on y axis x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1 parallel to y axis. Okay, so now we can identify the region bounded by these four. Okay, so these two lines and these two curves, so the required region is will exist in first quadrant. So this is the required region and it is y is equal to 1 minus x square, the region which will exist in first quadrant. So that is the required region here. So according to given problem, so here in the region, the given region, so there is a vertical strip. Okay, so vertical strip will exist, so let it some PQ. Okay, so here the vertical strip in the region, so which will extend from P to Q, the point P to the point Q. At P x is y is equal to 0 and at Q y is equal to square root of 1 minus x square, that is given limits. Y is equal to 0 and y is equal to square root of 1 minus x square. Okay, so the vertical strip parallel to y axis, that is extending from P to Q and sliding along x axis. Sliding along x axis from which point to which point? From 0 to 1. X is equal to 0 to x is equal to 1. So that is about according to given limits. Okay. So now by changing the order of integration, so we have to change the limits. Okay. So that's why this vertical strip becomes horizontal strip. Okay, so vertical strip becomes horizontal strip, like in the given region. So we have to take horizontal strip. So let it some RS. Okay, so clearly it is extending from R to S and sliding along which axis? Sliding along y axis. So sliding along like this. Okay, so extending from point R. At point R, what is the limits? X is equal to 0. X is equal to 0 to, and it is x is equal to what? X is equal to square root of 1 minus y square. Okay, so x is equal to square root of 1 minus y square. Okay, so these are x limits. Okay, so y limits we are taking as x limits. X is equal to 0 to x is equal to square root of 1 minus y square. Okay, so we are taking, by changing the order, we are taking horizontal strip which is parallel to x axis and which is extending from R to S, from the point R to the point S. At R, the point is x is equal to 0, and at S, the point x is equal to square root of 1 minus y square. And this horizontal strip RS, so which is sliding along which axis? Y axis, right? So which is moving from this point to this point. So here y is equal to 0, y is equal to 0 to here y is equal to what? Y is equal to 1. So now the new limits, the change in limits becomes like x is equal to 0 to x is equal to square root of 1 minus y square, and y is equal to 0 to y is equal to 1. These are the change in limits. Okay. So now by using these limits, we have to evaluate the given integral. Okay. So now let us see how to evaluate by using new limits. So the new limits are x is equal to 0 to 1 and y is equal to y is equal to 0 to 1, x is equal to 0 to square root of 1 minus y square dx and then dy. So by given column, first we have integration with respect to y. So by changing the order, first integration with respect to x, okay, and then with respect to y. So and here the integrand is y square. So you know partial differentiation, right? So while doing partial derivative with respect to x, treating y as constant, and with respect to y, treating x as constant. Like that, here we are introducing partial integration. So like partial differentiation, we are playing here partial integration. So when integration with respect to x, treating y as constant, and integration with respect to x, treating x as constant. So here, first, integral limits belongs to, after changing the order of integration, the integral limits belongs to x. So first integration with respect to x, and treat y as a constant. So here y square, there is y square, right? So y square treating as constant. So you can take it out, y square. So integral y is equal to 0 to 1, take out y square, and x is equal to 0 to root over 1 minus y square or dx and then dy. Okay, so now integral y is equal to 0 to 1, y square integral 1 into dx is what? X. Integral 1 into dx is x, and x is equal to 0 to square root of 1 minus y square dy, and put the limits. Upper limit minus lower limit. So this is equal to integral y is equal to 0 to 1 y square. Now put the limit, upper limit is what? Under root of 1 minus y square minus, and lower limit is 0 and dy. Okay. So this is equal to integral y is equal to 0 to 1 y square root over 1 minus y square dy. So to evaluate this integral, we are using substitution method. So put y is equal to some sine square theta or cos square theta. Okay. So then dy becomes sine square theta derivative 2 sine theta, and sine theta derivative is cos theta, and theta derivative is d theta. Okay. So these limits here belongs to y. We are changing y in terms of sine theta. So we have to find theta limits. So further, if y is equal to 0, find corresponding theta limits. So theta is equal, if y is 0, then sine 0 is 0, right? So theta becomes 0. And if y is equal to, upper limit is 1, then theta sine pi by 2 is 1. So theta becomes pi by 2. Theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2. Now the new limits. Okay. So now this is equal to integral theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2. Okay. And the y square means y is equal to sine square theta. Y square is equal to sine square theta. And root over 1 minus sine square theta. And dy. Dy is what? 2 sine theta. 2 sine theta into cos theta into d theta. So you can take common 2. Integral 0 to pi by 2 sin 1 minus sin square theta is cos square theta. So sin square theta into cos, root cos square theta is cos theta, cos theta into cos theta is cos square theta and d theta. So multiply and divide with 2, 4. Okay, so 4, 2 sin theta cos theta is sin 2 theta and the sin square 2 theta d theta and the limit 0 to pi by 2. So this is equal to 1 by 2 into sin square theta, you can write 1 minus cos 4 theta by 4 and the limit 0 to pi by 2. So you will get 1 by 2 into cos 4 into 1 by 2 is the cos pi by 2. Cos 1 pi by 2, cos pi by 2, cos pi by 2 value 0, so 1 by 4 is equal to 1 by 16. So finally the value of the given integral is pi 1 by 16. Okay, so this value is integral 0 to 1, 0 to square root of 1 minus x square y square dy dx is equal to 1 by 16. Okay, so this is about change of order of integration, evaluation of double integral by using change of order of integration. Okay, thank you.